Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Here, I am explaining you applications of binary tree in this video series. Before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Let's start with one of the applications of binary tree is nothing but expression tree. So, a binary tree is nothing but the variation of the expression. So, an expression tree is nothing but the variation of binary tree, and it is used to represent the expression in the form of binary tree. So, if I want to represent any of the expression in the form of binary tree, it will look like this. And after constructing it, here you can see that every internal node corresponds to the operator and every leaf node corresponds to the operand. Now, the construction steps for the expression tree from the prefix expression as already explained in my previous video. So let's start to solve the example to understand the algorithm. Here an algorithm I have mentioned, and from which the things which are mentioned in the black color are different than that of the expression construction from the expression tree construction from the postfix expression. So my first step is to find out a reverse of the prefix expression. So this is the prefix expression with me, and let's execute the step 0 to find out a reverse of the prefix expression is nothing but we are going to reverse it, and after reversing it you can see this is nothing but the reversed form of prefix expression, that I am going to mention it as a postfix expression. That's why my step number 1 and henceforth I am going to use the word postfix expression, because this is reversed form of prefix expression. So let's execute the step number 1 to scan the first character is nothing but operand, and if it is operand, what we have to do in the step number 2, that we have to push it onto the stack. So let's push it onto the stack. Step number 3 will not be executed because it refers to the operator and it is not operators, that's why it will not be executed. And let's move to step number 4 to return back to step number 1 to scan a next character. A next character is also again an operand, so that's why by execution of the step 2, let's push that operand onto the stack. Let's move forward for the next step will not be executed. Let's move to step number 4 to return back to step number 1 and let's scan the next character. Scan character is nothing but the operator, and if it is operator, step 2 will not be executed. We will execute the step number 3 to construct a expression tree, subtree. The difference is that as far as the postfix expression was concerned, the first popped item is going to become a right child and second pop item is going to become a left child. But as the expression that we are going to use to construct an expression tree right now is in the reversed form, we are going to form, or we are going to use the step in reverse, that first pop item that are we going to make as a left child and the second one popped item that we are going to make it as a right child. So let's pop the first item and make it as a left child, second popped item make it as a right child, and after attaching them as a left and right child respectively, this constructed subtree that we have to push back onto the stack. Let's execute the step number 4, return back to step number 1 to scan the next character is nothing but the next operand once again, and by executing the step number 2, let's push that operand onto the stack. 3 will not be executed. By executing 4 step, let's return back to step number 1 to scan the next character is nothing but the operator once again. If it is operator, step 2 will not be executed. Let's move directly to step 3 and let's construct the expression tree. First pop item is going to become a left child, second pop item is going to become a right child, and push back the result onto the stack. Let's move forward for the next step to scan a next character from the postfix expression is nothing but operand. Let's push it onto the stack and let's move forward for the next step to scan the next character once again is nothing but operand once again, and as it is operand, let's push it onto the stack. After that, let's execute the next step for the same, and here we are going to scan the next character once again is nothing but the operator. As it is operator, let's construct a tree by popping 2 consecutive items from the stack and make them as a left child and right child respectively, and after that push it back onto the stack. Let's move forward for the scanning of the next character. It is nothing but the operator once again. So let's construct a tree. For the construction of tree, the first pop item is going to become a left child, second pop item is going to become a right child, and push back the final constructed tree onto the stack once again. Now at the end here you can see that we have done with all the characters, and that's why this is nothing but the constructed tree from the postfix expression. So after construction of the tree from the postfix expression, it will look like this. And here are the some observations where this is the postfix expression. We have already done with this expression in my previous video, and the constructed expression tree will look like this, and this is nothing but the prefix expression. And here you can see that, here you can observe that the constructed tree is just same as of the same constructed tree from the postfix expression. So this is the form of the prefix expression of the same postfix expression. That's why the constructed tree are looking like each other. So for your reference, I am providing you some of the solved examples. Here you can construct an expression tree from the given expression and you will get the result like this. You can try these things by your own and you can check whether the constructed tree is correct or not. So this is the third solved example and you will get the result like this. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment, as well as do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link of the next video of this video series, and the whole video series also I am providing you in the form of playlist. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.